Hi everyone and welcome back. So in this video we are going to talk about all different variations of architecture, like currently we are using Next.js, GraphQL and the REST APIs and all these things. So we will go through the different possibilities, how we can build it. I don't want to make it more complex for my viewers, so let's see the different approach we can use. I mean, we can divide the whole sections into the two parts. And first we will do the easy thing and then we will go for the complex things, okay? Because introducing the GraphQL stack currently may be too much. I have already created a separate playlist how to write GraphQL queries and mutations, but that's on you if you are interested. Otherwise we will go with the approach 2, which is talking about plain and simple create React app, which is doing a client side rendering on the React on the client side. And we will do the reverse proxy with the help of Nginx. Nginx will just redirect us to the respective services based on this endpoint. When you are hitting API v1 user, it will take to the auth service. When you are hitting API v1 restaurant, it will take you to the restaurant service. But you will not be, the client will not know which service we are hitting because there is Nginx sitting in Bitmin, okay? And these are all different microservices. And each and every service should be able to talk to auth service for checking the authorization of the user. That is a traditional step we have to do if we go with this approach. Like restaurant service, you are calling directly restaurant service. But we have to validate if this user is valid, the role, user type are valid or not. Similarly, if you are going to directly any particular service, we have to talk to this auth service through the HTTP to validate the user and its data. Okay, this is the existing one which we are currently working on, and we have written a few things already in this. We are using Next.js for server-side rendering. We have the API gateway. This is nothing but a gateway service written in Node.js, which is calling the respective microservice using just making an HTTP call. And this API gateway is exposing the queries and mutations. We have already written auth microservice and the restaurant service. And we can now plug in play with the API gateway, which is nothing but a GraphQL API gateway. And our Next.js at the client side will send us the query and mutation from the Apollo client. And this is Apollo server, right? So this is the architecture, you can call it as a 0-1. But from the different reviews on my channel, I found out, okay, let's not do it complex at the initial level. We already have the React code. Let's convert it into the Create React app client side and simply use Nginx to redirect the call to the respective microservice. So we will move to the architecture 2. We are not going to do the big bang change. I will just do a simple changes on the client side code because it's now going to be the client side rendering, Create React app. And REST, we already have this restaurant service and authentication service, so we can use as it is. I will talk about how we did the setup with this Firebase, like what all Firebase credentials you will need here in the auth service and what all credentials you need at the client side. So with that we already covered, but I will do a quick recap. And then we will again start with the Next.js and writing these REST services, okay? Which this Nginx routing we have to write. So we already have, I think, one Nginx config. I mean, we are going to have Nginx container. What this container will do is, it's like this. If we are talking about the local setup, on the front end, maybe Swiggy microservice. When you are calling restaurant, it will call to the Swiggy microservice or Swiggy restaurant service. Let's call this is another microservice we have, and this is the container name for that microservice. This is the container name for that microservice, and all are running on 3000. So from this endpoint, Nginx will route this to your microservice and respective endpoint. So we will use this strategy because I think this is more simplified and comfortable for the large audience to understand the React code first and all these different microservices, how the communication is happening and how we are building the components at the client side. Okay, so stay tuned. I will do some changes and I will push that on the GitHub, and then we will connect with the next video.